And welcome back to another edition of DXB Today. Today, well, it's all things food. A little food for thought for you out there on what is an extraordinary foodie landscape. So to help us with the discussion, who better to bring into the conversation than our next guest? I've mentioned a little bit earlier on that we've got culinary creators, two world-class award-winning chefs. But you know, the egos need to be kept in line here. And there's only one person to do that, that's the curator, the manager of lifestyle festivals at Dubai Department of Economy and Tourism. Basically the brains behind the Dubai Food Festival, along with her team. It is a warm welcome to Alreem AlRedha. Thank you so much indeed for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me, it's a pleasure.
It's a pleasure because Chef and I were just reflecting on the fact, it's 11th edition.
11th edition, it's crazy.
And we were just talking about how the food landscape here in Dubai has exploded in recent years. And a lot of that has to be down to the influence, the impetus supplied by the food festival. Is that something that's shared with you and the rest of the team?
Yeah, honestly, it's amazing to see the huge growth that we have seen from, you know, the first edition of the food festival to now the 11th edition. Yeah. I mean, we can see the amount of international chefs that have come here to Dubai, specifically chose Dubai to, you know, come up and open their restaurants and start their businesses here in Dubai only tells you so much. Mm. But also the homegrown restaurants here in the city, such as Indigo and India by Vineet, you know, a lot of them have succeeded and have grown so much since opening up here in Dubai. And a lot of them have, you know, gone international. It's amazing to see. And besides that, there's also all the amazing, you know, street food eateries and all the hidden gems here in the city who really, you know, contribute a lot to the Dubai food scene, and it's amazing to see the growth.
Yeah. Now, this season, I'm quite excited about this 10 dirham dish that you have going on, but I know that's not the only thing. What are the key events that you have in this edition of the Dubai Food Festival?
So one thing that, you know, one of my personal favorites, one thing I have to highlight is the Dubai Restaurant Week. So basically this year we have more than 60 participating restaurants, you know, all of them offering set menus. So we have the two course lunch menu and the three course dinner menu. Lunch is for 150, dinner is 125, and dinner is 250. We have an amazing lineup of the restaurants as part of Restaurant Week. We have restaurants like Filia, we have Somewhere, we have Arabian Tea House, we have 21 Grams. Mm. I mean, you know, it really is, I always say, a good chance for everyone to go out and try some of these amazing restaurants at very attractive prices. Mm. It's amazing to see.
I'm already hungry just talking about
Go for it.
From my point of view, I think when it comes to gastronomy, we always look up to the government of how you can support. I mean, DFF, I think it's just been phenomenal. Now, we all know there's been a great growth in the past 11 years, but what is the next step, the next future? Where do you see it going now?
So Dubai Food Festival is, you know, I would say the highlight or the spike of what we do as Dubai Economy and Tourism. But we also have a year-long calendar of different events, different activations, different ways where we can basically support the F&B industry. I mean, mainly our main objective with everything that we do is to make sure that we are able to support the restaurants. With anything that we do, we make sure that it will ultimately lead to increased spend and increased footfall to the restaurants. You know, and we do that by ensuring that we have a wide range of restaurants that are participating in any of our activations. So, you know, ranging from street food restaurants to restaurants in malls to fine dining restaurants in hotels. That way we ensure that we attract the largest possible number of audiences and ultimately lead to increased footfall to the restaurant.
I mean, we have seen through our restaurants in the past years that each time when we have a food festival, we get a lot more new audience coming to a restaurant because, you know, the price point is perfect. Mm. You're showcasing to a very large audience, which normally we would not be able to reach out. So thank you for that. But what I would love to see, and as you said, homegrown products, homegrown restaurants. And this is where I think the Dubai Food Festival has a great catch. Mm. It showcases the local talents. This also attracts a lot of people from internationally who want to come in and set up new restaurants and showcase the best of Dubai.
Yeah. Alreem, I know we're only in the last few days of this year's Dubai Food Festival. The Eand Beach Canteen is always one of my absolute favorites, but I know you introduce things each year, like you said, 10 dirham dish. You've got foodie experiences this year. What do they entail?
Yeah, so foodie experiences has been here for several years now as part of the Dubai Food Festival. I mean, it's basically a collection of different experiences, different events, different sort of offerings that restaurants organize for residents and for visitors. So what it is basically things like chef's menus. We have things like cooking classes for kids, cooking classes for adults. There's things like, you know, culinary collaborations and that sort of thing. I always say, yani, it's always a nice, it's a different way to explore food in the city.
Yeah.
If you're not into the whole, you know, going out to restaurants and just sitting and eating there, that's, food experiences are another way for you to explore the food scene in the city.
Amazing.
Last, it's just amazing.
Last bit of advice for all of our viewers out there, and there will be tourists tuning into this, there'll be residents, there'll be citizens from all backgrounds, 200 different nationalities, all different price points as well and budgets as well, with a couple of days left in the food festival, the 11th edition of, is ongoing. What's your advice? What's the best way for people to experience it?
So go on DubaiFoodFestival.com.
Yeah.
That's where we have things that are free and we have things that are, you know, ticketed and paid. Mm. DubaiFoodFestival.com will be your basically gateway to find out anything about the Dubai Food Festival. But really, honestly, I really encourage everyone to just go out and explore Dubai's food scene. Like you said, it grows day by day and there's new restaurants every day. So I always say Dubai Food Festival is the perfect opportunity for anyone who wants to explore new restaurants. DFF provides that for you. And there's,
it's a great window, isn't it?
Exactly.
Because it gives you a window. You don't have to do every, how many restaurants are involved this year?
More than 700.
Yeah, you can't do that in 3 days. You can't do that, you're going to get ill if you do that in 3 days.
We can give it a jolly good go,
you
can't
we? Give it a little bit of a nudge. But it's a very good way of looking and going, okay, I'd love to try that. I'm not going to have enough time this time, but I will do it at some point in the future, correct?
Yeah, 100%. And there's so many different things. If you like street food, there's, you know, 10 dirham dish where so many street food restaurants are participating and offering their dishes for only 10 dirhams during the festival period. There's things like, again, Dubai Restaurant Week. There's Chef's Menu, which is focused on fine dining restaurants. So basically, these chefs are creating menus out of only their best-selling dishes. Whatever you like, I mean, there's something for anyone.
I think in many ways you get hooked onto it because, you know, you've done it this year and you enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And you want to come back next year and try a few more.
100%.
Exactly.
And sometimes you have your favorite restaurants on the list, you know, and you want to go there for a great price, a great value.
And highly recommend Chef Anit's offerings as well.
Well, bless you. You have very good taste.
Alreem, thank you so much indeed.
Thank you so much.
Food festival, as always. Yet another extraordinary festival from you and the team. So thanks so much indeed for your time.
Thank you so much. Stay with us
because we want to just cast a little bit more of an industry spotlight. Katie's got some more details.
Absolutely. Today's spotlight is on a soft serve food truck offering delicious vegan and reduced sugar soft serve ice cream, reshaping the old school classics with a little twist, catering to the growing demand for healthy plant-based frozen treats in the city. This is Sylvain Perret from Niam.
So my name is Sylvain Perret. I'm the co-founder of Niam, a low-sugar vegan soft serve bar. Miam means yams in many countries, especially in France. And this is what the company is about. It's about health and it's about taste. I mean, with Miam, we're trying to help people to have a better relationship with food. Many people struggle when it comes to dairy product or heavy sugary product. And people came to us saying that they didn't have ice cream for a long time or the vegan product is usually in the market not very tasty. So what we decided to do is to provide a product which is healthy, indulging, low sugar, vegan, and then this for them to reconnect with a style of eating which is much healthy for them. I mean, opening Kozal Fest in January, we built a truck in 4 weeks, and then during the opening, we had an instant hit, so it was an amazing milestone for us. We want to develop Miam on a large scale in GCC via a franchise model. We want people to be able to find easily Miam and to have a better alternative in food. I mean, I've been living in Dubai for many years and I think it's an amazing environment for innovation and entrepreneurships. They have a great vivid ecosystem and great talent. So for me, it's clearly a great place to be.
Yet another example of an extraordinary initiative helping to, well, yet further bolster the food landscape here in Dubai. Right, it's time now for the roundup. Louis, it's over to you. What do you have for us?
Ooh, this is good. Since we're talking about the Dubai Food Festival, as part of the Dubai Food Festival, there are hundreds of restaurants participating in the 10 dirham dish. So they're serving up their signature dishes for only 10 dirhams. Some of our favorites include a burrito from Chalcos, vegetable wontons from San Juan hand pulled noodles, lemongrass chicken grill from Saigon, and Alfredo pasta with garlic bread from Nice Italian Kitchen. The full list, of course, can be found on that website, visit Dubai's website. This is until the 12th of May.
Was that really necessary? Was that really necessary to list all of those foods at this time of night?
I started salivating. It's difficult just saying all these dishes. Now, since you're here, Alreem, I'm guessing you've pretty much tried many of the dishes from these 10 dirham dishes. What is your favorite? Is there a particular
one?
There's only so much I can try.
Is there anything that you would like to try for 10 dirhams that you've never tried before?
All of it. For 10 dirhams. I think that just goes back to the conversation we were having. I think a lot of people, you know, it's great to have the big foodie guides in town. That's a great vote of confidence for everything that Chef Anit, that Dubai Tourism have done over the years, and the great wealth of talent that A, have come here, and B, that have grown up here as well and expressed themselves. But, and there is a but, there are a lot of people go, oh yeah, but I can't afford Michelin. Sure. I can't afford Michelin, and I'm nowhere near that. You know, I can't. The 10 dirham dish is again, one of those windows of opportunity, because it doesn't need to be Michelin, it doesn't need to be whatever. It allows you to try a restaurant or something from a restaurant, or maybe even a cuisine that you haven't tried before, and go, oh, you know what? Why was I thinking that in the past? And it's just, it opens the mind a little bit. I remember that when the original food festivals, I think it was the 30 dirham dishes, etc. And again, you'd go to restaurants that ordinarily you wouldn't walk into because you'd feel out of place. Try a dish, and I've been going ever since.
I mean, very much like restaurant hopping. You can try a few of them. Yeah. And you can choose your own favorite. You know, everybody has their own preferences of what you like, what you don't like. You know, it is just about you exploring the wonderful culinary landscape of the city.
Yeah. Right, we are. Again, thank you so much indeed, Alreem, for being with us. Really kind of you to join us. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Right, we are not going anywhere though. Stay with us right here on DXB today, because this is what is coming up.
From creative workshops to hit artists, Fadis checked out the third edition of the Micro Mutech Festival at the Al Serkal Avenue that took place just over the weekend.
Plus, we're exploring the ever-changing dining landscape in the city with ex-BBC chef and podcaster James Knight Pacheco. Plus, we have a canoon performance to end the show. Don't go anywhere.